Have you noticed how the signs at the side of the road glow at night, particularly when the headlights of the car hit them? I wonder why that is so. Can you think of what you could add to paint to make those signs that would give it reflective properties? You might say, oh, that's easy. I'd simply put mirrors in the paint, because you know very well that when you look in a mirror, you can see yourself. Light reflects back. The problem is, if you move a little bit to one side or the other, you lose that reflection. Light will only come back when you're straight in front of that mirror. However, if you put two mirrors together at right angles to one another, you get a very different property. You find that it doesn't matter now from which angle you look at those mirrors. In fact, I can always see myself in those mirrors, provided I'm on the same level. And in fact, if I move to one side, I can still see myself. You can probably see me. You may be able to see the camera lens as well, because you have two mirrors at right angles acting as a very special kind of reflector. That'd be the good sort of reflector to have in the paint if you could get enough of them and make them small enough. It would be even better if you could put three mirrors at right angles to one another, because now you don't even have to be at the same level as the mirrors themselves. I can see myself right in the corner of those mirrors, and I can move my head around up and down, side to side, and I will always see myself down there. The reason? Because light is hitting one mirror, bouncing across to another, across to the third, and then back again. Excellent kind of reflector, but rather cumbersome to make up in millions and put them in paint. However, there's an even better reflector, and maybe this is getting closer to the answer that we want. The ordinary old glass marble, a sphere, acts as a very good reflector, because when light strikes a glass marble, it's bent at the surface, it bounces around inside that sphere, but a lot of it comes straight back along the line of the light that originally hit it. So if we could make up millions of those and put them in paint, we'd be on the right track. But just imagine paint with marbles in it. Be awfully thick and gooey, very hard to paint on road signs or anywhere else. We need smaller glass marbles or beads. They're easy to make. If you get a nice strong gas burner like this, get the flame very hot and take some glass tubing, you'll find that it's relatively easy to melt that glass. Many kinds of glass anyway. Look what happens as the glass melts. It rounds up into a tiny little sphere, almost a perfect sphere, just as drops of water on a leaf in the morning round up and form perfect spheres, so does molten glass. There's one perfect sphere, and I guess I could easily make up a whole lot of those, and we'd have something that's getting nearer to the sort of thing we want for that special reflective paint, but they're still a little big, aren't they? Well, there are special factories that make minute glass beads far smaller than that. How do they do it? They melt glass, then a blast of hot air blows the molten glass up a chimney. Every little piece of molten glass rounds up into a perfect sphere, and you end up with this. You might say, that looks like white powder. It is a white powder, but it contains millions and millions of perfect glass spheres. And when you mix that up with paint, you have reflective paint, the sort that's used on road signs. And if you look closely at one of those, you may in fact see some of the little spheres. You'll need to get very, very close, and it's even better if you have a magnifying glass, because then you'll see the tiny little spheres that give that paint its reflective properties. So, glass spheres or beads are useful on road signs. They're also useful on the stripe down the centre of the road, and also on that sticky tape that you may have seen on the backs of cars and bicycles that help you to observe them when you're travelling at night.